हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ अमी मेहता एंड इन डॉट नेट लेक्चर सीरीज नाउ वी डिस्कस ऑपरेटर्स इन डॉट नेट। सो इन प्रीवियस वीडियो लेक्चर्स वी हैव बेसिकली सीन व्हाट इज डेटा टाइप एंड हाउ एक्चुअली इट वर्क्स। ओके, नाउ लेट अस डिस्कस इट। सो व्हाट इज ऑपरेटर? सो ऑपरेटर इज बेसिकली विच ऑपरेट टू थिंग्स। For example, a telephone operator, what its task? Its task is to operate the telephone system. So in .NET, in any language, what is the concept of operator? So it basically handles two operands. So for two variable A and B. So if if any particular thing that handle these two variable and give some output is called operators. So an operator is a symbol that tells the compiler to perform specific mathematical or logical manipulation. So for perform some mathematical or logical task, there is a symbol and which tells the compiler to perform specific mathematical task or logical manipulation. So this is called operator. So in operator, based on its characteristic, we have distinguished it into different types. So the first type of operators are arithmetic operators. So the following table show all the arithmetic operators supported by VB.NET, in which we have to assume that variable A holds 2 and variable B holds 7. Then what will happen? So these are the arithmetic operator in the .NET. So the first operator is, the symbol is like this, and it raise one operand to power of another. So for example, 2 raised to 3, 3 raised to 4, 4 raised to 2. So this raised to operation is performed by this power operator, and B raised to A will give 49. Why B raised to A give 49? Because the value of A is 2 and value of B is 7. So 7 raised to 2 is 49. Next operator is plus operator. So this adds two operands. So A plus B is equal to 7 plus 2 will give us 9. Okay. Now minus. So subtract second operand from the first. So what it do? It subtract A minus B. So 2 minus 7. So it will give us minus 5. Then multiply operation. So it multiply both operand. So A multiply by B, which is 7 multiply by 2. It give us 14. Then the next arithmetic operator is division. So it divides one operand by another and return a floating point result. So for example, B multiply by A, which is 7 multiply by 2, and it will give us 3.5. Likewise, the divides one operand by another and it returns an integer result. Means there are no floating point values. So in this B divide by A, 7 divide by 2, but the answer is not 3.5. The fraction part is removed and the answer will be 3. Okay. So the next operator, the next type of operator is comparison operator. So the following table shows all the comparison operators supported by VB.NET. Assume here a variable A holds value 10 and variable B holds 20. Then what will happen? So these are the list of all comparison operator. So the list are here: double equal to, then not equal to, then greater than, less than, greater than equal to, less than equal to. These all are the comparison operator. So you have to remember this comparison operator list. Okay. So first is check if the value of two operands are equal or not. If this equal, if the condition becomes true, otherwise the condition becomes false. So here A is equal to B, but the value of A is 10 and value of B is 20. So 20 is equal to 20. This condition becomes false. So this condition is not true. The second one is check if the value of two operands are equal or not. If value are not equal, then condition becomes true. So here we check. 10 is not equal to 20. Yes, 10 is not equal to 20. That's why the condition becomes true. The next is greater than. So checks if the value of left operand is greater than the value of right operand. If yes, the condition becomes true. So here we check whether the 10 is greater than 20. Condition is not true. Then A is less than B. So checks if the value of the left operand is less than the value of right operand. If yes, then condition become true. So A less than B is true. Now greater than equal to. So checks if the value of left operand is greater than or equal to the value of right operand. If yes, then condition become true. So A greater than equal to B. So 10 is greater than equal to B? No. So the condition is not true. Then less than equal to. So it is a check if the value of left operand is less than or equal to the value of right operand. If yes, then condition become true. So A less than equal to B is true. So this is all comparison operator. The next type is logical or bitwise operator. So following table shows all the logical operator supported by VB.NET. Assume variable A holds boolean value true and variable B holds boolean value false. Then what happen? So first we list the operators: logical operator, bitwise operator. So this is AND, OR, NOT, XOR, and also OR else, is false, is true. What is the task of this operator? So first let us discuss AND. It is the logical as well as bitwise AND operator. If both the operands are true, then condition become true. But here we assign the value A true and B false. So the condition become false because both operand are not true. The next is OR. So it is the logical as well as bitwise OR operator. If any of the two operand is true, then condition become true. So from A and B, the single one is true, yes, then the whole condition become true. So A or B gives us result true. The next one is NOT. It is the logical as well as bitwise NOT operator, and it is used to reverses the logical state of its operand. So A and B, so the answer of A and B is false. Now we apply the true in the this value, so it will give us the true, because the reverse of the invert of the false is true. The next one is XOR. So it is the logical as well as bitwise logical exclusive OR operator. It returns true if both expression are true or both expression are false. Otherwise it returns false. So A X or B is false because the value of A is true and the value of B is false. That's why the value of A X or B is false. If the value of A and B both are true, then it might be give us the result true. The next one operator is AND also. So it is the logical AND operator. It works only on Boolean data. Okay, so A AND also B is false. But this AND also operator is only work with logical operator. It is not bitwise operator. The next is OR else. It is the logical OR operator. It works only on Boolean data. So the A or else B is true, is false. It determines whether an expression is false or not. Is true, it determines whether an expression is true or not. So these are the bitwise or logical operators. The list is AND, OR, NOT, XOR, and also OR ELSE, IS FALSE, IS TRUE. So in this session, what we discuss, just quick revise it. We discuss what is operator and what is the various types of operator. From that, we are only here see total three types of operator. So the first one is arithmetic operator, in which we see the power, the addition, subtraction, multiplication, division with fractional point and floating point value, division with integer value. In next, comparison operator, in which we discuss double equal to, not equal to, greater than, less than, greater than equal to, and less than equal to. Okay, so and the next one is logical bitwise operator. And here we'll see AND, OR, NOT, XOR, and also OR ELSE, ELSE, IS FALSE, IS TRUE. Okay, so these are the three types of operator. The remaining operators we will discuss in the next video lecture series. Okay, I hope all of you enjoyed this session. Thank you.